Hello everyone, I'm Rajesh from ACM Technology. Last class I give you some exercise, right? And this class I'm going to solve that exercise. And I hope you guys already finished the exercise. If finished, it's very nice. If not, then please look this video. So let's start. First I'm going to calculate average, ABG. So I have to ask user input 5 numbers, right? So ask first number. Input is enter a number and the B also same, please not input, just enter is nice, enter second number. This is nice, of course not, because you have to write 5 times, right? So why not we write in single line? Of course you guys already know. So B C D E, right? Single line. Please enter five numbers and separate with comma. You want to separate this comma, you have to write split right here, and here comma enter. You understand this one, right? So anytime when you need to calculate sum, no, average, you have to find sum first, right? Let me calculate sum equals to A plus B plus C plus D plus E, right? So this is sum, correct? So you can add these numbers here. You cannot add this number. Why? Because now the number is between double quote here. You see, between double quote. If number is between double quote, that means that is string. So you have to change this is in string into integer. You see here, see enter here of string. So you see string. That's why I have to change this R into integer. For that, what you have to make bracket and you have to write here int, correct? Same like this, I'm going to also change b int. I'm going to change also c int, also d int, and last one int, correct? So you see, I send all this number int. So now I can calculate the all number and they going to sum, add on sum. You see now, see sum is int now. But if I delete these things, cut, and let me write just a b and capital B C D E. Control yes. You see now here. However here. Is nothing? Nothing here, right? Why? Because this is now is nothing because not integer. This is not integer, so you cannot add, right? That's why I have to put this one, and now you see integer right here. So I get sum right here. After sum, if you need average, just ABG equals to sum divide, how many element here, 5, right? Divide 5 and they print ABG. Very easy, right? If you want to calculate average, you just have to ask user 5 number or 6 numbers and they change that number string to integer and assign as sum. Why sum? Because I see I add this numbers, right? So I assign as sum. And if you want to calculate average always is equal to sum divide element. So 5 elements here, so divide 5. So I want to print average. So now I show you. If you want to run, you have to write Python and this file name, right? File name is sol.py. enter 5 number separated with comma. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see 3. Why here have point? Do you know why? Because I put here single. Single means floating, right? And also let me calculate 1, 2, 3, 3, 6, 4, 10, and 5, 15. 15 divided 5, 3. If I put here double, so what do you think? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Enter, just 3. Why? Because I put here double. If I put double, that means this is going to convert into integer. So integer don't have point. But if I write here single, that means have point. So you have to write here single, because maybe our answer is 0.3.1, 3.2. So we have to write this one, right? So this is the first way how we calculate average. But also have the second way. Directly here you can do. Just write ABG. Delete this. And this make here all things between bracket. And here you can divide 5 directly. Now you can see. Add all these numbers and divide 5 is average, right? I hope you guys already know these things. 5 number 2, 3, 4, 5. Just want to take a small number. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3 point. The last one is here. Right? So, if you, what about if I want to enter big number? Yeah, 10, comma, 20, 30, 20, 10. 5 numbers, yeah, enter. You see 28.0. You can add here 30 40 70 70 20 90 90 and 5 95 50 140 140 divide 5, yeah, 28. Very easy, right? And very interesting. And the second thing is, now I'm going to solve the question number 2. So question number 2, ask user his name and print back, right? So reverse. So let me ask user his name. So input. Please enter your name. Make a space bit here. And then just print his name, right? Yeah. But you want to print his name back, right? So you want to print his name back. What you have to do here? Remember step argument -1, correct? Starting, ending, and the -1 means from back side. So you see, this is a name from here. What you just want to print, and that start from 0, end until finish. -1 means from back side. Enter. I want to enter Rajesh. And let me show you. You see, enter Rajesh, and you see answer this. Let me run once again. Something else here. RAM Ram. You see, Ram is Mar. Very interesting, right? And this is second question. Let me print third question. Ask user his name and check length, right? So it's also very easy. Just print, and you have to write len and bracket his name, correct? Run 6. You see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my name length is 6. So you guys already know these things, right? Let me review one more thing here. Count. So how do I count? It's very easily, just name dot count, count and bracket which one number you want to count. Maybe I want to count A. done, and I'm not going to ask user to enter, just I'm going to very easily Rajesh, because it's easy to tell you. So let me count A, how many times A here, just one time, right, because see, A just one time. What about K A, now, 7 times, so this is count, you already know, right? So already we learn string method. So today I finished this, what is our target, already finished, and next class we are going to learn something very nice. So see you in next class. Stay tuned, goodbye.